What's new in accessibility at Google? Hey everyone, it's Eve Anderson here with another episode of What's New in Google Accessibility. Today we'll be discussing some exciting product updates for Gemma, Android, Pixel, Chrome and Chromebook, and Workspace. First up, some exciting news that was just announced at Google I.O. Later this year, we're releasing SignGemma, our open model for sign language understanding. While we focus the most on American Sign Language, ASL, and English, SignGemma will be trained to translate other sign languages into spoken language text. And since it's an open model, experts in other sign languages can fine-tune their languages. It's a Gemma model, which means we're making its core technology publicly available for anyone to download and use, to build new tools, adapt it for other sign languages, or create the technology they envision. This approach opens up new possibilities for community-driven, accessible tech by and for the deaf and hard of hearing community. Watch for SignGemma's release. This doesn't take the place of human interpreters, but it can be helpful for people without access to one. Shifting to the latest features for Android, we've expanded Gemini's integration into the TalkBack screen reader. So you can now not only receive AI-generated descriptions for images, but also get a description of your whole screen and then ask conversational questions and get responses. That means the next time you're shopping online for an outfit, you can ask TalkBack to describe all the outfits shown on the screen and even follow up with questions about which ones are on sale or in a certain style. In other exciting Android news, last year we released Expressive Captions, a feature of live caption on Android, and it just got even better. Expressive captions can automatically capture the intensity and nuance of how someone is speaking in most of the audio and video you encounter on your phone. And now, with our new duration feature, you'll know when people are dragging out the sound of their words for emphasis, like when a sports announcer is calling out an amazing shot, or when the statement is not no, but no. The latest version can also capture even more sounds, whether someone is whispering, yawning, or clearing their throat. It even works with live or streaming content that doesn't have preloaded captions. Moving on to the latest Pixel news, the Magnifier app has introduced Live Search, designed to help blind and low vision users find things in their surroundings more easily. Instead of needing to take a picture first, you can now type out what you're looking for, like a gate number at an airport or items on a menu. As you move your phone, Magnifier will highlight matches on the screen, and your phone will also give a little vibration when it finds something, letting you search for and find the information you need more quickly. Last year at I.O., we unveiled Project Astra, a research prototype exploring the capabilities of a universal AI assistant. In addition to strong enthusiasm overall, we received overwhelming interest from the blind and low vision community to be trusted testers. This year, we're pleased to announce the Project Astra Visual Interpreter for people who are blind or low vision, built in collaboration with professional visual interpreting firm Ira. We're selecting a small set of users to join the Trusted Tester program and test this research prototype, which is built into Ira's mobile app. People can use their phone camera to scan their surroundings and ask questions like, "What do you see in this room?" or "Tell me when you see a backpack." Project Astra responds in real time, describing surroundings, finding items, or reading signs. A live Ira agent supervises every session for safety and quality. While still experimental, we hope this will bring us closer to an AI that is truly useful for the blind and low vision community. For more information and to sign up as a tester, see the Project Astra microsite, linked in the description below. Now, let's talk about the latest accessibility features for Chrome. Previously, if you opened a scanned PDF in your Chrome browser, you wouldn't be able to use your screen reader to interact with it. Now, with Optical Character Recognition, OCR, Chrome automatically recognizes these types of PDFs so you can highlight, copy, and search for text, just like you would on any other web page. You can also use your screen reader to read the PDFs without the screen reader identifying them as images. The latest for Chromebook includes the ability to turn off the touchpad, helpful for those using screen readers to avoid accidental clicks. We're launching flash notifications, which flash the screen whenever a new notification arrives. This can be helpful for people who are hard of hearing or those who use screen magnification and might miss regular notifications when zoomed in. Several other new features are geared toward those with limited dexterity and/or tremors. Bounce keys ignores repeated keystrokes within a short time interval. And slow keys requires keys to be held down for a set amount of time before they are registered, preventing unintended characters from being entered. And to help those with difficulty or pain using a mouse, there's now mouse keys, a feature that lets users control their mouse pointer via the keypad. Last but not least, a quick update from Workspace. Users can embed interactive Google calendars into a website. These embedded calendars are screen reader compatible and have improved spacing to make text easier to read, plus a responsive layout that adapts to different screen sizes. You can also easily navigate the embedded calendars using keyboard shortcuts. Well, that concludes this episode of What's New in Google Accessibility. Thank you for tuning in. For more information, be sure to check out the video description below, where we've provided links and additional details for many of these updates. To learn more, sign up for our newsletter at g.co/a11y/news, or by clicking the link in the description of this video. See you in a few months for the next update. What's new in accessibility at Google?